Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Fly ball out toward left center field. Left fielder giving chase. But he won't get to it. And this should put him in scoring position to start the inning. Terrell isn't stopping. Here he comes to the plate. Safe at the plate. As they push their lead to 3 now.
Boy, the home fans are loving that inside to Parker. Looked like he was carrying a piano around his back when he rounded third, but he made it. Somebody get him an oxygen mask.
Nigga!
The show is at the gateway to the West, St. Louis, Missouri, and lovely Busch Stadium. This evening, we've got a matchup out of the NL Central Division between the Chicago Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals. Cardinals baseball is straight ahead, next on the show. Zach Gallen gets the call for game one of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have it.
Next to hit, Cole Roederer. He was 1-for-4 with a two-bagger in yesterday's game.
Cole Roederer.
Here comes the 1-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Terrell will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. Now to the plate, here is Mario Terrell. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The center fielder, Mario Terrell.
Pitch on the way. Wind up and the 0-1. A swing and a ground ball to third.
Come on, beat it out, beat it out, beat it out.
There's one down to lead off the frame.
Three.
So the lineup. lineup flips over and digging in, Mario Terrell. He bounced out last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
He's set and the pitch.
No, that's down.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Come on, let him fly right here.
Ready with the 1-1.
That's a ball.
And he lays off for a ball. 2-1. Bottom of inning number 3. Nothing-nothing our score. Swing and a miss there, and it's 2-2.
Two strikes.
2-2. Here it is. And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. The love of the game runs deep with these folks. Back with more on this Monday night after this. Start of the inning, and into bat next, the versatile weapon, Javier Baez.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
And the leadoff man gone now to start the fifth. To hit is Mario Terrell, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
And this is popped up near second base. Simeon is there, and the side is retired. Make it 6 shutout innings as he continues to give them fits out there. We're through 6 full, and we still have no score.
3.
And that brings up Javi Baez. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Now a swing as he rifles this one into center for a base hit. Only the second hit he's given up tonight.
Yeah, Matt, he's locked in and pretty dominant since the first. So as long as he can get back in that groove with the next batter, he's not going to worry too much about it.
That'll bring up Jason Hayward. He has flied and lined out in 2 trips in this one. The windup and the 0-1. Ani pops it up. Rogers over to his left. He's got it one away. Leverage at bat here, and standing in, it'll be Mario Terrell, as he'll do his best to bring home the go-ahead run from third, 90 feet away. Comes set, here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Grounded to the right.
Stand up right here, stand up.
First
stand
of the second out, but meanwhile, that all-important go-ahead run is in to score.
Really good job of putting the ball in play right there. Even though it wasn't a base hit, it does.
Here's Javier Baez, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. And this ball swung on and hit to center field, and this should do it. He makes the catch, and the Cardinals have taken the opener here at home as this ball game is over.
Always nice to get the first game of the series, but even more so when it's in front of the home crowd. Seems to energize everybody the rest of the series.
This evening's game finishes 2-0 the final score. The St. Louis Cardinals came through late, taking the lead in the eighth to secure the victory. Pitches his way to a team-leading 12th win of the year, allowing only a pair of hits in eight full innings pitched. Kyle Hendricks pitched well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. Kirby Yates earns the save out of the bullpen, number 36 on the season. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Tonight's paid attendance at Busch Stadium, a sellout, 45,529. The Cardinals would like to thank you for joining us. Please drive home safely.
Yo, we got chicks in the living room getting it on, and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning. O's for Uchi. Oh, you ain't know how many O's in the bankroll. Sort of like the game show, who wants to be a millionaire? But my name ain't Regis. Nah, the one they call when they want their thing beat up. Honeys with bodies, deep brave hearts, guns in the party. Waves, braids, balls, trademarks, the army. Is that...
Tuesday Night Baseball now from the home of the Cardinals, Busch Stadium in St. Louis. Tonight, the second of three to start the week between the Chicago Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals.
And that,
we've got baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Miles Michaelis, a right-hander from Florida, gets the ball as the starter here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, one of the keys to this guy is throwing strikes. He's not a big strikeout pitcher, only averages less than...
Up next, Mario Carroll.
Batting second, the center fielder, Mario Carroll.
Hey, you can know better up there. Let's go.
He's set. Here it comes. Good pitch there as he gets him to swing underneath it for strike one.
Hey, either this hitter needs a cup of coffee or he was sitting off speed right there.
Here's the 0-1 pitch. He swings and misses. Throw down. He's not in time. Pretty close, but he got in there safely.
This catcher has an elite arm. But when you get that great of a jump at first base, it makes it a lot easier to steal second.
One away. So that'll bring up Jason Hayward.
Now back, right fielder, Jason
Rivas at second, Roederer at first, two out in the inning. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Carroll will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. Cubs strand a couple. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Next, former National League MVP Chris Bryant. Here comes the 1-2. Hit hard right back up the middle, and he's got a leadoff single.
Hey, there's a base hit to lead off the third inning. Talk about having a lot of traffic, D-Roll. He's given up several hits already, so he's been in the stretch most of the game.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Dan. That is the name of the game for this offense. They're trying to get this guy in the stretch, hopefully.
Stays Stepping in next, David Bodie, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Two outs here with a runner at third. Fly ball out toward left center field. Center fielder giving chase. As he arrives at second without a play, as also on the play, a run comes across to score. And time will be called here as the pitching coach heads out to the mound and hopefully try and settle this guy down a bit. Bases are loaded here, two men gone, and that'll bring up the multi-gold glover, Jason Hayward. Comes set, the 0-1, lifted in the air out to center field. Terrell is there, and he puts it away as they're able to escape with only limited damage on the scoreboard. So they do get three that inning. That's the good news. The bad news is they leave three men on base. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. It's the Cubs 3 and the Cardinals nothing. So here is Mario Terrell grounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Bryant's got it.
Go, 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 dig, dig, dig.
Two away now. Safely. First pitch of the AB now. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and that's through for a hit.
You know, D-Roll, the old school thinking sometimes is when you're going through a bad streak like this guy, any way you can get on a little jam shot. Even though it wasn't pretty, maybe this could get this guy finally going.
Yeah, I can't tell you how good that had to feel right there. There's moments where you slap that donut off your bat, you don't even want to walk to home plate. You're sweating it so bad.
Second, Terrell on at first with two down. Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him, and the inning is over. Cards strand a couple. They trail it here 3-0. See if he can come through in a clutch spot here. Two on, two out here in inning number six. The 3-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Cubs strand a couple, but they're on top by a count of 3-0. Again is Afonso Rivas. A couple of singles to his credit thus far. The 2-2 coming now from Price. Hit in the air to center field. Terrell is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
Hey now. Got it. 4-4. Take your base.
So stepping in is Mario Terrell, singled in his last at bat.
Mario Terrell.
from the stretch. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on.
Here we go now. Come on now. One time.
Now a throw over to first.
No, he's
back in standing.
Find something you like up there.
He's running. Rolled slowly down the third baseline. But a foul ball, 1-1. Now this is slowly hit to short. Probably too slow.
Come on, get here.
And boy, just about overshot his man at first, but he's able to keep a foot on the bag over there, and that's out number two.
Ball four, take the base.
Three.
That's ball four.
Into the box, Javier Baez. Lifetime versus this arm. He's a 300 hitter, 3-for-10. He's taken him deep once. Here now the 2-2. Hit in the air to straightaway center. Terrell is there and he makes the catch for the out. Dial it in here, going up against one of the best strikeout relievers around.
All right, come on now, one time.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. And this one's down off the shoe tops, 1-0. Now here's the pitch. Sneaks a fastball by him at the letters. It's 1-1.
Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
1-1 pitch is a knuckle curve. He's in the hole now, 1-2. Fastball, but that's easy to lay off, and it's back to even at 2-2.
Hey, have a good rip up there, huh?
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
Now the 3-2 pitch. And that is the start they were looking for, down by two, as that misses for ball four.
That is not the way he wanted to start off this half inning. It's one thing to walk the leadoff hitter, but it's even more painful when the leadoff hitter is an absolute burner and he can really wreak some havoc on the bases.
Next, here is Nolan Arenado. It was a walk in his last trip.
Arenado.
And he misses there for ball four. So runners are at first and second now with nobody out.
The closer is supposed to slam the door on his opponent, but he left the door wide open with a walk there. We'll see if they can capitalize on it.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Tyler O'Neill, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Spinning a throw back to second, and he just manages to get his hand in. Terrell leads off second with nobody out. And he'll strike out here yet again. It's been a ballgame to forget thus far. 4 strikeouts.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him. And he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
Runner at second, one away, and in to hit next, it'll be the ever-versatile Chris Taylor. Working for the punch-out and the offering. Here's ball four.
And with first base open, the last thing he wanted to do was give him something to hit in the heart of the zone. So no harm done. Force out anywhere now.
Brendan Rodgers bats next. He went deep earlier, and he's 2-for-4 to this point. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now, with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
Now back, the right fielder, Jorge.
Cardinals down to their final strike here. And he struck him out for out number three. So that'll wrap things up here as they leave the possible tying run stranded at first. 4-2 the final score tonight. The Chicago Cubs led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Cristobal Caballero gets to double digits with his 10th win of the year. Craig Kimbrel wraps it up for the save, his 24th on the season. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
For St. Louis, two runs, nine hits, one error. They left 22 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 54 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance at Busch Stadium, a sellout, 45,529. The Cardinals would like to thank you for joining us. Please drive home safely.
First opened in 2006, we're at beautiful Busch Stadium in St. Louis, Missouri. Today it's an NL Central Division matchup between the Chicago Cubs and the St. Louis Cardinals. It's baseball on the show, and it's coming up next. Kwangyoung Kim is on the mound for the Cardinals. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, one of the things this guy does really well, neutralize the left-handed hitters. On the season, lefties are hitting under 250 against this guy. So whatever he's doing against lefties, it certainly works.
He's out.
Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. It was a three-hit effort from him last night, so he was a big part of that victory. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Terrell is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Three up, three down for the Cubs. It's the Cubs nothing. Cards coming up. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Thank you. now in the box, Mario Terrell.
The center fielder, Mario Terrell.
He's set. Here it comes. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. Dan, D-Row, the Cubs, as they take the field here this afternoon, 4-2 over their last six games, including a win last time out.
Hey, thanks, Matt. You know what, D-Row, you got to give this team a lot of credit. They're on the outside looking in on the postseason picture, but boy, they're playing out the string and they're playing out well. They're going to play this thing all the way to the end of the season.
You know, Dan, I can't speak for the pitcher side of it, but I have never been on a team, win, lose, or draw, whether I was going to the postseason or not, that had players that gave away at bats. You just will not see it at this level.
1-2 now. Swing and a liner.
Come on, ball, get on up.
And that's in there.
Round it.
Base hit.
Pick up the ball.
And that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. Head-to-head numbers against Zach Davies. Batting 500, 5-for-10. He's also driven in 5 runs. Second, Terrell at first with no outs. And he won't even have to take the bat off its moorings. A 4-pitch walk here.
He's definitely stumbled out of the starting blocks here in the first, giving up a couple of base knocks on that walk. First innings are often some of the toughest for a starting pitcher.
Ready now is Colin Moran. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night. The 0-2 pitch. And a swing and a miss on a huge first out there as he sets him down swinging with the bases loaded.
I'm really impressed by that strikeout, and I'll tell you why. He should have gotten a call on the pitch before, and it looked like he got squeezed a little bit. In a bases-loaded situation, that can drive a guy nuts, drive you crazy. What I loved is he didn't let him take him out of his game, and he came back with another good pitch and got the punch out. A really nice job of taking it one pitch at a time.
Brendan Rodgers bats next. 9 at-bats for him in the series so far, and he's collected a pair of hits. Hit on the ground to third. There's one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, the side is retired. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. We're off to the second, scoreless on the show. Hit his first time up.
Yeah, and they take another single right here. That third base coach is dying to wave his arms. I wouldn't be surprised if anything hit hard through the infield. He's going to wave them.
First pitch of the AB on its way.
Nope, that's
a ball and no strikes.
Ball one, no strikes.
Chopped weakly to the left. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Wide for ball three.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Full count here. Here comes the pitch.
He's got a good feel for his off-speed pitch his second time through the order. And we just saw three in a row.
And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings. Next to stand in is Nolan Arenado, who threw a base on balls his first time up.
Arenado.
Here comes the 1-2. A bouncer to the left side.
Pick up the ball right here on the bat.
Come on, come on.
And he indeed takes only the out at first as the runners move to second and third with one away now. So now here is Colin Moran, who went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big-time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
3-0 pitch. And he misses with it. Ball four. So that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball.
And this is the kind of thing that's been happening to him all season long. He'll cruise for a while, hitting his spots, and all of a sudden the wheels come off and he struggles. We'll see if he can recover here.
And this is swung on and missed. Oh, a huge punch out there as the bases remain loaded with two away now.
Well, I have to give credit to him on the mound for not letting that previous pitch get to him. He wanted it, but he didn't get the call. But I love how he didn't let it affect him. And he comes right back with another good pitch and gets the punch out.
And now, Chad DeLaGuerra. He bounced out last time up. Walton on third. Terrell at second. Moran on at first with two down. Swing and a line drive.
Dig hard. Just going, go.
And not in time as the run scores. And the run is in the score from second. It's a 2-0 ball game.
They not hit all that hard, D-Roll. Muscle it out there for a 2 RBI base hit.
Yeah, I don't care, Dan. Long dart, off the end of the bat, jam sandwich, doesn't matter. Found himself some green grass and gets two ribbies.
So the bases are empty with two gone now. And stepping up to hit next, the catcher Wilson Contreras. No runs, no hits, no errors so far for the Cubbies. High fly ball out to straightaway center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Can't start any better than this. He's set down the first 12. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. Cards lead it 2-0.
Three out. Ball four, take the base.
So next to bat will be Jason Hayward. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
And there's out number two as this is taken in shy of the track, and the runner will have to retreat. And now here is Mario Terrell.
The center fielder, Mario Terrell.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Fly ball out toward left center field. Left fielder giving chase. But he won't get to it. And this should put him in scoring position to start the inning. Terrell isn't stopping. Here he comes to the plate. Safe at the plate. As they push their lead to 3 now.
Boy, the home fans are loving that inside to Parker. Looked like he was carrying a piano around his back when he rounded third, but he made it. Somebody get him an oxygen mask.
Time up.
All right, come on now.
Nico.
Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Terrell is there. Two gone. Start in this one, 2 for 2, including a home run. Now a move over to first, and he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely.
What a rip right here.
He's set, and the pitch. Walton is off of first with two away.
He drifted up there.
Now a throw over, and he'll get back in safely. And again a throw, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. Fastball well outside. Four runs, nine hits, and no errors so far for the Redbirds. And he fouls this one off.
Halfway to the plate, this hitter's wondering why he even pulled the trigger on that. His hands feel like he's being stung by wasps right now.
Runners off for second. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. It's a run on two hits, one left. We're through six full. The Cardinals are out in front, 4-1.
Save guys in the league right now. He's been very reliable shutting the door.
1-1. Swing and a line drive. That'll make him 1-for-4 in this one. Leadoff hitters aboard, and that means the tying run will come forward here in the late innings.
Well, you're usually in this situation looking for a bloop and a blast. He didn't want to bloop it, and he hit a missile, bringing the tying run to the plate. Let's see if they can capitalize.
Ball four, thank you, man.
Swap this one. Three pitches, gets the out, and heads to the clubhouse to celebrate. Can't do much better than that.
One run finish recorded to be the final tally today. The Cards led this game from the third inning on and never wavered. Kwon Young Kim earns win number 7 on the season. Kirby Yates earns the save out of the bullpen. 7th of the year. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
For the Cubs, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors. They left 7 on base. Time to the ball game, 3 hours and 7 minutes. Our paid attendance this afternoon, 46,000. The Cardinals would like to thank you for joining us and remind you to please drive home safely.
School me to the game, now I know my duty. Stay humble, stay low, blow like Hootie. True pimp, nigga, spin no dough on the booty. When you yell, there go Mace, there go your cutie. All the spots.
rock all the rocks, top all the drops. I know you're thinking now when all the ball is stopped. Nigga never home, gotta call me on the yacht. 10 years from now, we'll still be on top. Yo, I thought I told you that we won't stop. Now what you gonna do with a school that got money much longer than yours? And a team much stronger than yours. Violate me, this a BOJ. We don't play, mess around, be DOA. Be on your way, cause it ain't enough time here. Ain't enough lime here for you to shine here. Deal with many women, but treat down's fair. And I'm big.